It's a national crisis. While Indigenous Australians make up only 3% of the national population, in prisons around the country, they make up over 27%. In Alice Springs Correctional Centre, a staggering 90% of all inmates are Aboriginal. Carla Grant was given rare access to the centre and filed this report about what it's like on the inside.
My name is Norbert Morris and I come from Nirupi community, which is west of Alice Springs, 6 hour drive.
My name is Patrick Magalese. I'm from Santa Teresa community.
My name's Leroy Gibson. I come from northwest of Alice Springs.
It's early morning here at the Alice Springs Correctional Centre. It's a prison like so many others across Australia, with its barbed wire fences and relentless daily routines that Norbert Morris knows only too well. Today, Norbert is serving breakfast to fellow inmates Leroy Gibson and Patrick Hayes.
Breakfast!
All three men are re-offenders and are serving time for a range of offences, mainly involving assault. As Indigenous men away from country, it can be difficult adjusting to life in prison.
Go work. Work. Fix that thing. Table.
I miss going hunting with my family, going around, playing football, playing guitar, playing basketball.
What's the date today? Next week? Then the week after? I'm going back home.
What I miss most is all my brothers, my grandmother, but she lives in town. Back at community, I just miss my language, like Aranda people. No?
Life in prison is a world away from life in community.
When you need, like you gotta follow the rules. Every morning we get up, have a breakfast and have a shower.
Hi, Fitz.
And get dressed. After that, we wait for officer to come around, unlock the doors, and they get us out for master.
Hey, fellas.
Morning.
Morning. Everything all right?
Yes.
Hey.
Hey.
Yep.
Hayes.
Yes, miss.
Workers went through to the dining room.
Can we go to work? We do our work there. We work. Maybe 8 hours, from 8 o'clock to 3 o'clock, and we come back 3 o'clock. That's 7th every day, you know.
It's clear order and routine are important here, but the question is, how is this preparing these men for a life after prison?
It's no good effectively coming and spending 3 months, 6 months or 12 months here in the correctional centre and walking out the door with nothing better than when you came in.
The authorities here wanted to find a program that would prepare people for life after jail. And what they found was an innovative computer program called iTalk.
You're in jail. What are you going to do? What can you do?
It's really for me about linking up a 40,000 year old culture, or 40,000 years plus culture, with 21st century technology.
The iTalk Media Production Training Program is run over 10 weeks. Through specially designed computer software and digital technology, the inmates learn how to create their own personal stories and educational videos, both in English and in language. The program is run in partnership with media production and training company iTalk Studios and the Northern Territory Department of Correctional Services.
Basically, we handed a computer over to somebody who'd never used a computer, and these guys picked it up really within about 15 minutes, these guys actually started to understand how to make a story, and it was actually very, very empowering.
There you go, you run. Someone's chasing you. Look back this way. Oh, quicker.
Through illustrations, animation and music, the inmates produce a variety of work, all communicating important messages through storytelling.
That's how we can translate it in our language to the other prisoners, helping them to understand how the prison system works.
Yeah. We create our own stories for the department, so it might be work health and safety, it might be driver education. We work with other government agencies, and then we also allow the prisoner to create their own stories.
Passenger was telling the driver to drink. Driver said to him, "Stop unpacking me."
So how important is the iTalk program, do you think, for the prisoners here?
It's very important. So when everyone get to iTalk, they will know everything, like new skills, attitude.
Do you think it's giving the guys skills to be able to be successful on the outside?
Yeah.
Leroy is an accomplished singer and songwriter, and this program has been an outlet for him to create his own music.
I'm looking forward to look after the family, look after my grandmother, and my father and my mother, and my sisters, nephews and niece.
We call ourselves free people.
While there are many positive things happening here, nobody underestimates the enormity of reducing the Aboriginal prison population. But they're hoping these programs will help people lead better lives on the outside. What are you looking forward to the most when you get out of here?
Just want to get out and go back to push, keep doing what I'm doing here, yeah.
All people have to do is just focus on what they're doing. Like, they have to get on the right track, look after their families, look after our community, and look after our elders and families. And that's the main thing that keeps people are from this place, you know.